Good morning. The purpose of this video is to help you virtually through the VSEPR modeling lab while I'm doing your student-led conferences. So hopefully you have some feedback from me when I can't come around and helping you to help you. So one of the purposes of this lab is to see what the bond angles are when you build your different geometries for your different covalent compounds. This is the most simple covalent compound you are going to build. Something with two atoms, well, any two points makes a straight line, and it's really pretty straightforward how to get the bond angle from that, because the bond angle is going to end up being 180 degrees, just like that. I'm pointing to 180 degrees. Straight lines are 180 degrees. That's what you'd put on your lab. Now, this could be a review from geometry, but if I have three atoms and I've got an angle, like I say, I'm going to have this here, looks like that. You'll notice that hopefully both of the lines on each side are equally distant and have the same distance in between these two atoms on the very ends. The central atom is going to act like the apex of your angle. You're going to move your protractor over. You're going to flip it around. And you're going to read, and I will guarantee you that this is not an answer for this lab. However, I can read here, the ray is pointing to about 145 degrees, and I know I read the bottom set of numbers because the angle is obtuse. So this particular bond angle, if it really existed, which you will find out it doesn't, is going to be 145 degrees. So now, what happens when I've got a molecule that's going to look three-dimensional? Because when you build some of these things, you'll find that the atoms and lone pairs will only be as far away from each other as possible if you take on a three-dimensional shape. And that makes all sorts of sense because we live in a three-dimensional world, so molecules are going to be three-dimensional. So I'm going to show you a little trick here on how to draw things in your notebook three-dimensionally. Now, if you're an artist, you don't have to listen to this set of directions because you are probably a better artist than I am. What you do here is you pretend that anytime you've got just a straight line, that straight line is on the page. Anytime you've got a dashed line, the dashed line is going out of the page. So what I mean by that is here is a dashed line. And it's technically, if I draw it dashed, it means that the atom is going behind you. Now, what if I have an atom that is actually facing towards you or out of the page? How I depict that is I choose a little triangle. I take the triangle and I make a wedge out of it. And the wedge means that it's going to be going out of the page towards you. So then all of a sudden you've got a molecule that almost looks three-dimensional. It almost looks like a pyramid shape where this particular atom is on the page, this particular atom sticking out towards you, and that particular atom is going to be going away or in the back of the page. Now it's going to be hard for me to model on a video that's two-dimensional how to use your protractor. The angle will not be accurate, but again, the central atom is going to be the apex of your angle, and you can use that to turn it and measure the angle of the model that you created out of styrofoam and toothpicks. So again, this is a really, really, really short video to help you with the lab as I'm doing your student-led conferences. If I have a break in between, of course, I will answer questions. But that's going to be my first priority today. Good luck and have fun.